sharing a secret recipe of paneer matar restaurant style, or probably you could call it as a dhaba style. If you like my channel, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe by hitting the bell icon so that you get an update on the latest videos of my channel Food Venture Folks. Okay, so let's begin with the recipe. For this preparation, we need 50 grams of sunflower oil, 1 tablespoon of salted butter, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 4 to 5 slit green chilies, 1/2 kg onions which are finely chopped, 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic crushed in a pestle, 1/2 kg tomato puree. So what I've done here is I have taken tomatoes, boiled and then given them a blend in the mixer. We need coriander leaves for garnishing. Now we move on to the masalas. We need 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric powder. Here we need 250 grams of paneer, 250 grams of green peas, equal in quantity, and 1 secret ingredient, which is the breadcrumbs. Okay, so let's begin with the recipe. We take oil in the pan. Simultaneously, we'll add butter in it. Okay, now we add the cumin seeds. Mix that for a while. Okay, now we add the green chilies. There goes the onions. Let it cook for a while. We'll saute this till golden brown. Let it mix very well with the chilies. Okay, so our onions are getting fried nicely. So it's slightly, you'll see that it, you know, it's changing its color from pink, it's slightly turning golden brown. Let it cook. Keep mixing it very well. This is a very important step so that the onions don't stick to the bottom of the pan. So keep mixing it. We need to cook the onions very slowly on the slow flame so it, you know, it gives a better flavor to it. Okay, so now you'll see that the onions have slightly turned golden brown. It's slightly changed its color. So now it's the right time to add the ginger garlic, the crushed ginger garlic that we've prepared. So here goes the ginger garlic. Keep mixing it on a high flame. Now we add the tomato puree which we've blended. Give it a nice stir. Give it a nice mix to it. So now it's the time to add the dry masalas. So we have the red chili powder, the turmeric powder, the cumin powder, the coriander powder, and the garam masala powder. We add all of this together. Give it a nice mix. Okay, so guys, what I've done here is for the red chili powder, I have added degi mirch as well as Kashmiri mirch. So what it does is basically you use your degi mirch to give it a strong spice flavor, and your Kashmiri mirch is used for color. So you should adjust it as per your taste buds. Okay, so now we let this cook for a couple of minutes or so. Okay, so 2 minutes have passed. Let's open the lid. Wow, beautiful. Look at the color. So when you actually see the oil getting separated from the masala, that's the time when you should realize that the masala is very well cooked. Okay? You give it a nice stir. Now it's time to add the breadcrumbs. So even if you don't have breadcrumbs, that's fine. You can probably add cashew nuts or watermelon seeds, people in the market. Yes, one important thing is that both of it should be equal in proportion. Okay, so now we've added the breadcrumbs. At the same time, we'll add water to it so that it mixes well. We'll take a glass of water. Breadcrumbs are usually used to thicken the gravy. Okay, that's where I was saying that you can probably add cashew paste or the watermelon paste. Okay, so now it's time to add the green peas. Let this cook for at least 4 to 5 minutes. So you can just put the lid and let it simmer. Okay, so now let's open the lid. Wow, look at that. What a lovely color and what a lovely texture as well. So you keep moving it because you should not allow the masala stick to the pan. So just in case if you find that the masala is very thick, you can add water as per your requirement, the way you want your gravy to be. This is the exact consistency that we need. Look at the thickness. Okay, so now let's add our paneer. Lower the flame. So when the green peas looks like it's, you know, almost 70-80% of it is done, it's almost cooked, that's the time when you add the paneer. Because after adding the paneer, you can't really stir, right? So that's the time when you add the paneer. So now we add all the paneer in there. Mix it very well. Now comes last but not the least, salt. The magical twist. Add salt as per taste. Okay, so all viewers out there, just in case if you don't have breadcrumbs at home, what you can do is probably you'll have cashew nut paste and you may have watermelon seeds. Okay, so for all the viewers out there, if you don't have breadcrumbs at home, what you can use is probably you'll have cashew nuts or you'll have watermelon seeds. So you take 40 grams of cashew nut paste and 60 grams of watermelon seeds. Mix them well and add them in this mixture instead of breadcrumbs. Okay, so this looks almost cooked. Lower the flame. Give it a nice stir. Now it's time to add the coriander leaves. So we add the freshly chopped coriander leaves for garnishing. Okay, so now after adding the coriander leaves, the paneer matar masala is ready. So this is the typical restaurant style, or you could call it as a dhaba style. Look at the thickness of the gravy. This is the consistency we need. Mix it very well. Is exactly what we need. Look at that. Okay, so friends, this is how the paneer matar masala looks like once it's served on the table. So you can have it with bread, you can have it with roti, you can have it with rice, naan, etc. If you like my channel, please don't forget to share and subscribe by hitting the bell icon so that you get an update on the latest videos on my food channel, which is Food Venture Folks. Thanks for watching.